Okay, so now where we are right now, just share your screen. Okay.
1 minute. Screen sharing, you have to enable.
Okay, anyway, now try.
Yes.
Now share. Perfect. So what we did earlier, let me explain you in a short. We have created one domain controller. We have created one delivery controller. Into the delivery controller, we have installed all the core components of Citrix. Why we have installed all the core components of Citrix in the delivery controller? The reason is that just because we was running short of hardware resources, okay? And we have created one hypervisor, that is GenCentral 01, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And in that GenCentral 01, with the help of GenCentral application, we have installed one operating system as a master image, correct? And in correct. That master image, we have installed one virtual delivery agent, which is responsible for the communication with to our Citrix Studio, correct?
Correct.
So now we have already installed that virtual delivery agent in our master image. Now I want you to go back to your Citrix Studio, which is installed in delivery controller. Just switch your screen right now. Perfect. Log in there. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Now what we have to do, just click on machine catalogs. Have we created any machine catalogs? No. Or yes, even I'm not, okay.
Machine catalog created.
Okay, so we have already created the machine catalog. Now what we actually did, we have created one machine catalog from the master image. Okay, so as I already explained you, what is master image and what is a machine catalog. So now I want answer from you that what is the difference between master image and the machine catalog.
Master image is the main primary image. Okay. From that image, we can create the machine catalog. We have to create a group of that master image.
Okay.
Suppose if we create a group marketing or HR or something for master image. So if I want to create a number of system, if I create 5 or 6 or more than this, so we can create my multiple system from that master image. This
for
is the machine
catalog. Users or group, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so as we already created the machine catalog, now in this video, what we will do, we will create a delivery group for that machine catalog. As we have created that machine catalog, just suppose we have created this machine catalog for HR team, correct?
Correct.
So now what we will do, we'll create a delivery group for HR team only, okay? So now just click on the delivery group. And before that,
catalog and delivery group, what is the difference between?
I will let you know. Look, machine catalog, you can assume it as a virtual machine, okay? Which we have to deliver to our end users, okay?
Okay.
So how we will define the end users for that particular group? Like, we must have to create some groups, correct? Like if you have installed, just suppose if you have installed some particular application in your machine catalogs, like just suppose you have created the machine catalog for HR team, okay? So for HR team, what softwares will be required in that machine catalog? Outlook should be there, Microsoft Teams or Skype should be there. some kind of, you know, ERP software should be there for attendance perspective, and it may be differ as per the HR requirement. Got it?
Okay.
So just suppose we have created that machine catalog for HR. Okay. So now we have to publish that machine catalog to HR team only. Got it? So now what I want from you to go back to your domain controller. Log in there. Now open Active Directory, and I want you to create one OU for HR. Yeah, do right click there, OU. It's organization unit. Yeah, name it as an HR. Hit OK. Now into the HR, just create one user and name it as HR1. Username should be differ, but it is just for your identification. Okay. Now next, enter password. Okay. Finish. That is fine. Okay. And in the same way, you can create multiple users for that HR OU. Got it? So now go back to your delivery controller. Now what we have to do, we have to create a delivery group. So on your right hand side, you are getting one option to create delivery group. Just click on it. Click on next. So now we named that machine catalog as HR. Okay. So as you can see, you are getting one virtual machine available for HR group. Why? Because we have created only one machine catalog. Correct?
Okay. Right.
Click on next. So in that screen, now it is asking for users like to whom you want to publish that machine catalog. So what you have to do, you have to restrict that machine catalog to HR peoples only. Okay, so select the second option. Now you have to add some users, or you can add a group as well. Okay.
Okay.
Now search for that user that you have just created. Click on advanced. Check name. Okay, that is fine. Click OK. Now HR1 is now restricted to that particular delivery group. Like HR1 will be able to access that particular machine catalog only, which has been configured for HR group only. Got it?
So in this meaning, HR1 cannot log in that machine. What is the meaning?
No, look. The machine catalog that you have created, we have just restricted HR1 to access that particular machine catalog only. Okay. Otherwise, if just suppose if we select the first option, then any authenticated users will be able to access that delivery group, but we do not want that. Okay. We want
okay. That means any domain user can connect that machine. First one.
Correct. Correct. First one. So we do not want that. Okay. Correct.
Okay, right.
Okay, so in that way, you can add a user, or also you can add a group. Okay, so it's up to you.
Okay.
If you have multiple users in a single group, you can add that group. So whatever the users you have selected for that group, all those users will be able to access that virtual machine. Got it?
Okay.
Now simply click on the next. So now, if you have to publish some applications for HR people, you can add those applications. So click on add. And from the start menu itself, select the first option. So whatever the applications are installed in start menu, those will be listed here soon. Okay.
Okay.
So far, we do not have installed any application, means we do not have. Have you installed Office 365 and other stuff in your machine catalog or in your master image? No?
Nothing.
Okay. So for an example, just select Notepad. And look for any other application. Just scroll down. Nothing. Notepad is there. Or you can select. Just select RDP, Remote Desktop Connection. Remote Desktop Connection. Just below. Yeah. Click OK. And click on next. So listen, before click back. So now this is just for an example. If you installed any specific application like ERP or any other attendance software, okay, for your HR group, but those software must be installed in your master image. Got it? But as we are running short of hardware resources, so we didn't install any application. Got it? So these are the basic default application. Just suppose if you have installed Tally or ERP or any Acrobat, Adobe Reader, whatever it is, okay? So if you have installed those application in a master image, those application will get listed here, okay? So right now we are going with the default application, that is fine. This is just for the demonstration. I hope you can understand what we are doing right now. Okay. We are publishing.
One question I have. We can, master image, if we configure master image for HR group, okay. Mm-hmm. So why machine catalog is required?
Okay. So listen, just suppose you have created one master image, okay? Master image in the sense, have you ever used that Ghost application earlier?
No.
Okay, so that is fine. So why master image required? Okay, so just suppose you have, machine catalogs are the individual virtual machines for each and every user, okay? And master image is the main image from which you can create multiple of machine catalogs. Okay. So just suppose you have if you have 100 of users in your HR team. Okay. So you cannot deliver the master image to end users. Why? Because it is for your reference. Like just suppose if there is some requirement from HR team to install new applications. Okay. So what you have to do, you have to install that application in the master image. Okay. Then from that master image, you can create a separate machine catalog for HR team. Got it? So master image for each for IT prospective only. Got it?
But my question is that we are giving, suppose in HR group, if I divide some subgroup also, suppose if we provide some application in specific users, okay? So for delivery group, what is the requirement? That I cannot understand. Because I am not taking full image from the machine catalog, master image. I am taking only specific application in the delivery group. Okay.
Buddy. Session is not completed yet. Okay. And please do not get confused. We are publishing the applications along with the entire desktop. Okay. So now what I want from you, just click on next. You will get your answer in next slide. Now it is asking for desktop assignment. Okay. So just suppose you have some specific user to whom which you actually you do not want to deliver any desktop to them. Okay, so in that case, what you will select, few applications only, like when users get login to the your storefront server. Okay, so after that, user will be able to get two applications only, like Notepad and remote desktop applications. Okay, means you have to decide to whom you have to publish the entire desktop. Got it? So those are the part of common things. So now what I want from you, just go back to your domain controller again and create HR2. Click on next. Go back to your delivery controller. Now simply click on add. Name it as HR. Display name, it should be HR. Now we have to restrict that desktop. Click on the restrict desktop use. Now select here HR2. So what is it means, like your HR1 will be able to access two applications only, like Notepad and remote desktop connections. Got it? But your HR2 will be able to access the entire desktop, whatever the replica of master image. Got it?
Got it.
I hope you have got your answer.
No.
Why?
My question was, see, master image I created first, okay? So from master image, I am using, if I using delivery group, not machine Kerala, I can, if I create two part, suppose you are creating two things, one for HR, one for application and another for the desktop.
Okay.
So my concern is that I am creating the machine catalog system, the similar image of the master image. Okay. So what is the requirement of machine catalog? What is the advantage of machine catalog? The same image I am doing here, machine catalog. So I can do this activity from delivery group. So
listen. What is the master image? Master image is for you or for your IT team, okay? If you have to modify something in your master image, that you can do in your master image, you do not have to touch the machine catalogs, okay? So machine catalogs will be running parallelly for your end users, and the team for end users is HR, okay? So why we are not delivering directly delivering the master image to end user? The reason is that, because and just suppose if you are using any Windows server or any Windows desktop operating system, okay, so there is a limitation. Like, just suppose if you are using Windows server as an operating system, okay, so in that case we have some limitations. Like, we can publish that master image to specific, means to some limited users, like 10 to 15 or 100, okay? Because for each user login, we need some CAL license for Windows server. Got it? So to reduce that licensing cost, we publish the machine catalogs to end users, okay? So machine catalogs will be individual for each user. Got it?
Okay.
We cannot publish a single machine to all the users. Are you getting my point? So this is your answer. Now simply click on OK. click on next. If you want to enter any delivery group, you can enter like Windows Server 2019 or 2012, whatever you have installed. This is for you only, okay, not for end user. In the first row, okay, the delivery group name. Enter. Simply click on next. Click on finish. Now you have created a delivery group for two users like HR1 and HR2. Got it? So now what we have to do, we have to publish that machine to end user, correct? So just suppose if I am your end user and you are the Citrix administrator, okay? So I need some URL to access your virtual machine from my personal or office laptop, correct?
Correct.
So what is that URL? It should be your storefront, correct? So now what I want from you to just mount that ISO file to your delivery controller. So I have made you, I just made you as a admin, okay, and you might get one more invite from one of my students. Just check for it. If you got it,
connect, na?
Yeah, connect. How many participants we have? Okay. Click on connect.
Which ISO image I have to connect now?
That Citrix virtual apps and desktop. Okay.
Okay.
You just selected it. You have to connect it. Okay. Also, buddy, sorry for the delay. Actually, I was busy since last 2 or 3 days. So that is. I just click on removable devices. Click on connect. Now open CD DVD drive. Click on this PC. Click on no. Click nobody. Okay. Click on this PC. You have to open this PC, man.
This PC.
Yeah, File Explorer. Open your File Explorer. Click on this PC. To right click on your DVD drive. The second one.
Yeah. Right. Then
right click. Install or run. Now click on yes. Now what we have to do, we have to install the storefront server on this virtual machine, but in the production we will use a separate machine for a storefront server, but you know the reason why we are doing all the stuff on the single machine. Got it? So it will take a while. Wait for it. So now, as I explained you earlier, storefront is a URL for end users. Okay. So now we have to configure that URL for our entire infra, and that URL will use will be going to use web server IIS services. Okay.
Right.
So wait for it. So are you able to manage your memory to 32 GB? Yes or no?
No.
then we have to wait. Actually, you know, response will be slow, so do not worry. I also thinking to, you know, finish that class why yesterday only, but due to some personal issues I will not be able to join. And I have also seen some of your text, like you was telling me that I'm wasting your time.
You need to inform.
But is
you have personal, I told you previous day also, Jay, you have any problem, it may be problem, anybody can problem, but you need to inform. You are giving repeatedly new time, and I am waiting here. So
no, because I do not want to waste your time, no, but that was the reason, you know, I was trying my hard, but you know, somehow I was not be able to manage at that time actually. Okay, now what you have to select, storefront. Okay, click on it. It will install few web server IIS roles in your server. Okay. Wait for it. I accept and click on next. So what it will be do, what it will do, it will install Internet Information Services. Okay, click on next. Simply click on install. It will take a while and it may ask you to reboot your delivery controller, which is perfectly fine. Okay.
Okay.
Wait for it. Now, just check memory of your host machine and let me know how much memory.
13.7.
And is it okay to turn on Windows 10 machine as a client machine? Just power it on. And just let me know how much memory we have allocated to your Windows 10 machine. Go switch, check the memory.
512 MB.
Can be increases to 1 GB at least. Check the available memory in your host machine.
13.6.
Okay. Just increase it to 1 GB. And power it on. And you have already joined that machine into the domain, correct?
Correct.
Okay, buddy. Power it on. Go back to your delivery controller. It may ask you to reboot in the some time. Okay, it is quite slow, not an issue. Okay, it is almost done. Click on finish. Yes, click on yes. In the meantime, go back to your Windows 10 machine. Log in there. And now I want you to install two software in your Windows 10 machine. Now log in. Do you have internet connection active in that machine? No. Okay. So now do right click on Windows 10 icon. At the center of your screen. No, not from here. Yeah. From the top of your screen, from the top, do right click. Click on the settings. Now, click on add. Select the network adapter. Click on finish. Click on network adapter 2. That is on net. Click OK. So what we did, we have added one network adapter in your Windows 10 machine And with that network adapter, you will be able to access internet on your Windows 10 machine. Okay. So now
Okay.
internet is enabled. Now open Internet Explorer or any web browser. Open that. Now install Google Chrome first. I hope your internet is slow actually. Okay. Go back to your delivery controller. Log in there with the same user account. Go back to Windows 10 machine. Check for the internet. Why it's HTTP? Why it's HTTP? Okay. Perfect. Now type Citrix Workspace download. So basically, as I told you, Citrix Workspace is an end user application which is responsible to create a session from end user device to your data center. Okay.
Okay.
Now simply click on the first link. Okay, it is slow. No worries, wait for it. No, no, wait for it, buddy, wait for it. Go back to your delivery controller and launch the Citrix Studio. Do not click multiple times, okay? So do right click and open from your desktop. Do right click on Citrix Studio and open it. Now wait for it, click yes. Again, go back to your Win 10 machine. Why it's taking that much of time. Try to refresh. Do one th- okay. Okay, click on it. Anyway, do one thing, just download that application in your host machine, then move it to your virtual machine, okay? No, it's really slow actually. Which internet you are using right now, buddy? Just close all the unnecessary tabs open, okay? Anyway, go back to your delivery controller. Is it launch? Okay, it's still working. Go back to your host machine. Okay, download. Yeah, download it from here. Click on download for Windows. Okay, so just go back to your Zoom application. But you go back to your Zoom application. Just click on the dip in.
Application.
No, dip in. You are getting one user over there, dip in. That is called dip in.
Yes.
Click on it and admit it into the lobby, okay?
Not able to listen.
No. Just click on the dip in. Are you getting that dip in user over there?
Sir, I joined already.
Okay, buddy. How are you?
Fine, sir.
Okay, so we have one more colleague here. His name is Appu and he is from Bangalore. Okay. Actually, he's almost there that we have just completed earlier in our previous session. Like, you know, what we did, we have created one master image, and from that master image, we have created machine catalogs. Okay. And from yes, that master. Sorry.
Internet connection was disconnected. That's why.
Okay, so I think we have lost your screen, buddy, as well.
Okay, 1 minute.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so Dipin, what we did earlier, we have created one master image, got it? And from that master image, we have created a machine catalog. And from after that machine catalog, we have created a delivery group. And after the delivery group, we have created a storefront server. Okay.
Okay.
So have you forgot all the things or you still remember? Just let me know honestly. Okay.
Sir, actually, I forgot most of the things, but I'm trying to catch up.
No, why you are trying to catch up? Like, you do not have any practice at your
procedure,
home.
It is in my mind, but last 3 months I'm not mind. Looking on it that one.
Buddy, you are a technical guy. So why, like, you know, okay, so let me know honestly, just start from the beginning, what we did step by step. Okay. Otherwise I will continue with you after that session. Okay. Why you are laughing, man?
First we have done the initial setup, like a domain controller.
Okay.
And then we have installed a delivery controller in one of the machine.
Then?
And we have created a gen server.
Okay, then?
Then we have hosted some machines over gen server.
Okay, with the help of?
Gen sender.
That is fine. After that?
After that, we have created a delivery group and we have hosted some applications over there.
No, not delivery group. After that, we have created machine catalogs from the master image, which was hosted in our gen server. Correct?
Correct.
After machine catalog, we have created a delivery group.
Okay.
Not okay. If you don't remember, just let me know. I will host a specific particular session for you. Okay. But right now I'm with Appu and you know, I'm in the mid of something. So that is the reason why I asked you to join that session. Okay. So buddy, okay. Appu, have you downloaded that?
It is taking time.
How much? So, Dipin, you are in Oman or you are at your home?
No, I am in Oman.
You are in Oman only?
Yes.
Okay. And how things are going over
things
there?
Things are moving. Personally, it is moving forward, but in office, I am facing too much headache.
Okay. Why? What kind of headache it is? It is
no, actually the year-end issues and then IT asset issues and IT budgets for 2022.
Mm-hmm.
And the management, they are going to do some changes. So then their IT headache is in my head. It's on my head right now.
Anyway, rest of the things we will discuss on the separate call. Okay.
Okay.
So this is for your demonstration perspective only, like, you know, we have connected since I think it's almost over a month, correct?
No, I think almost 2 months over.
Correct, but you know, I was busy.
I know that your current situation, because you are running, you already told to me, no?
Yeah,
running,
you know,
with the family issues and official issues.
Family and medical issues, and you know, I was in hospital since last 2 months actually. So that was the major reason why delayed things are getting delayed actually. So Appu, is it not getting downloaded?
No, it is change similar page again and again.
Just click on download, set to workspace for Windows. No, yeah.
Here click I already clicked.
Nothing downloaded?
It is coming just like that. That's why I cannot understand why it is coming.
Okay. I have one alternate for you. Just go back to a delivery controller. Buddy, just go back to your delivery controller. Yes. Now, click on open that file explorer. File explorer open. Click on this PC. Click on this PC. I'm not asking to click your right click, just to left click on this PC. And on your DVD drive, do right click. And open in new window. Yeah. Now click on the support. No, I think I forgot the path. Go back. Click on the settings receiver and plugin. Click on the Windows. To be a receiver we have here. Now copy that. And paste it into your Windows 10 machine. So those are the shortcuts that I'm telling you right now, okay? No, I think first you have to paste that in your host machine, then you will be able to copy it in your... No, where you are copying it. But
the host machine, okay.
Okay, copy it, now paste it in your Windows 10 machine. Paste it and install it. It may ask you to reboot your host, like Windows 10 machine, okay? So,
okay.
Wait for it. I think you have not logged in with admin. Just enter your admin password. I think you have to select other user. Click next. No. Click on next. Again, install. Wait for it. In the meantime, go back to your delivery controller. So what we did earlier, we have installed a role that is called Citrix Storefront, okay? And with that Storefront server, we have installed BEV server IIS role in that server operating system. Okay, so now I want you to click on Settings Storefront. click on the configuration. Click on the configuration tab on your left hand side. In the mid configuration.
Okay.
Then storefront, the fifth option. The fifth option on your left hand, just below the configuration. Yeah. Click close that pop up. So now we have to add a storefront server here. Click on add a storefront server. Now it is asking for a name. Enter any. Enter any, your location, Indore, your name, whatever it is. Just enter DDC.
Okay. Storefront server name is the delivery controller server name, it will be.
No. Delivery controller in production, both are the separate things, okay? But right now we are using delivery controller, so you can enter DDC, okay? Enter. Into the description, you can enter anything. Like storefront 1, storefront 2, or whatever you want to install. Now, into the URL, just enter http://. ddc.yourdomain.com, because on that server we have installed BAF server IIS role. Got it? Wait for it. Now again go back to your Win10 machine. Is it installed? No. Go back to your delivery controller again.
No, installing.
Yeah, it will take time just because of hardware resources, not Andrew. Now, from your right hand side, click on the edit storefront server.
Hello.
Give me the controls. From your Zoom application, just give me the controls, okay?
Are you able?
I'm trying. Wait. I just clicked on add it to storefront server. Is it open?
No.
I'm not sure why it is happening. Let me check. Okay, just revoke the controls and do the step that I will tell you. Okay, just revoke.
Okay.
Click on the edit storefront server. Yeah.
Yes.
That is fine. Cancel it. Now on your left hand, just click on the settings storefront on the last. Refresh it. Refresh, click on refresh on your right hand side. It is taking a while, not an issue. Go back to your Windows 10 machine. And check, is it installed? No, it's taking too long actually. Okay, anyway, open that IE, Internet Explorer, on your Windows 10 machine. That Edge, Microsoft Edge, open it. And type here, http://, in the http://, not as http://, that ddc dot your domain dot com. Hit enter. Is it accessible? No.
Localhost
we can hit, but we are not getting any URL over there. Okay, so no worries. Go back to your delivery controller again. And now click on the configuration tab on your left hand side. Again, click on the storefront. Now, just give me the controls. I'm not sure why I'm not able to operate it. I'm not sure what is going on actually. Okay, do one thing, just click on the delivery groups tab below.
Okay.
And into the administrators. Click on the administrator. So right now Citrix admin have full controls. Okay, that is enabled. That is fine. Click on the controllers on your left hand, just below the administrator. Click on the controllers. Just below the configuration tab, click on the controllers.
Okay.
Have you clicked on the controllers?
It is showing ddc.it.local/registered/desktop1.
Now click on the hosting. Your Jan server should be added there. Click on the hosting. Okay, your Jan server 01 is connected here. That is fine. Again, click on the storefront. Just below the hosting.
Okay.
Do right click on that DTC. Click on add it to storefront server. That is fine. Cancel it. Click on that storefront server, setting storefront in the last. Why? That is not getting listed here. Click on the refresh on your right hand side. Close the Citrix Studio. Buddy, close that Citrix Studio and relaunch it again. It is taking much time. Close that. Wait, what you did? Okay, close that. And launch that Citrix Studio again, okay? Tipin, are you there? Buddy, you there?
Yes, I'm here. I just got on mute.
So I hope you are not getting bored because you have already gone through all that stuff, okay?
No, the idea, sir. I'm just catching up the things. Don't worry.
Okay, so on that time, good hardware configuration. So right now we have some slow hardware. So that is the reason why things are getting delayed. Anyway, I will take it further. Okay.
Citrix works, workspace app and other stuff. I know where.